There are two main findings from the Nun study. Again, these are nuns. They donated their bodies to the study of Alzheimer's disease. So Dr. Stone was able to assess nuns while they were alive for multiple years. And then after they passed away, they donated their body and brain to science. And in the study of Alzheimer's disease, that's particularly critical, as many of us know, in that Dr. Stone could analyze the brain pathology, the neuropathology of these donated brains after these nuns passed away. And one of the major findings was, in fact, for a fairly important subset of nuns, when they passed away, it appeared when looking at their neuropathology that they had Alzheimer's disease. They had accumulation of plaques, tangles, et cetera, neurodegeneration. However, while they were alive, they didn't show any identifiable symptoms of Alzheimer's. So that suggests that we do have an ability, a cognitive reserve, as you will, and how can we maintain that? How can we identify that? So that's one key finding. The second, which is very intriguing too, is that these nuns, when they first entered the convent, they were actually asked to submit essays as to why they were entering the convent when they were around 16 years old, 17 years old. And Dr. Stone and his team got access to those essays. He did a linguistic analysis of the essays, kind of trying to assess the complexity of language used, et cetera. And what he found was that those nuns that showed greater cognitive complexity in terms of their grammar and writing when they were 16 and 17 years old were less likely to die of dementia after passing away and doing postmortem brain analysis. That does really suggest to us the life course nature of Alzheimer's disease. And I would argue furthermore, if we are going to prevent and reduce risk as it relates to dementia or promoting brain health, it will likely require a public health strategy that focuses on brain health across the life course.